Hello and welcome again to Steve's Long Stay Workshop, where sets come to be looked at, it's been looked at elsewhere. Or in some cases, were interesting and I might manage to pick them up. This is such a set. In the 1950s, Echo and what other manufacturers came out with sets that had presets on the front and only three or four stations on the dial. They didn't take off. Apart from schools, of course, where, you know, they didn't want the kids tuning in Radio Caroline or Radio 1 or something. In Germany, they carried on with this, though, and they brought out sets like this. This is a Siemens set, UKW automatic, and it's VHF only. And five tuners on the front here, and it can be set to five stations, so it works in the same kind of a way. Now the chances are with this, it'll work straight out of the box. They do. Is it German? Well, German stuff does in most cases. Most cases works out of the box, and so this one I think probably will. Well, let's see, shall we? Transistor head, by the way, so.
Raven, this is Fly Away Tones and I at BBC Radio Manchester. And I had a dream.
No matter back home, no matter what I do. Right, well, it seems to work straight in the box. Does not mean, however, that we're just going to leave it, because obviously it needs something things doing to it to make it work better. And so go and have a quick look and see basically how it works, what's inside it, and take out one or two things that do need to be checked out on this set. So glasses please. Getting old, you see. Glasses please, and we'll go inside and have a quick look at this this quite interesting set. A lot of these sets actually, they work on 220 volts. Here we're on 239. Now, in the case of valve sets, that would be a problem. But transistor sets, I don't think it is. So we'll. So we need to find out how to get into it first of all, don't we? This one was made in Austria, by the way, Siemens, like I said before. So, looking inside it, like that, a lot of people would say, with this, if you have a look, a lot of people would say, change all the capacitors and stuff like that. I don't think this needs it, because there was no hum or anything just now. And for that reason, I'm going to leave it, apart from one or two small things which need to be checked to make sure that it's okay. The fuse, by the way, in this is okay. Yeah. The switches are okay and the buttons, so really, I think all this really needs is a quick spray. So that's what we'll do with it first of all. So where's my magic spray that's sort of many things out? There are some sets which, you know, you don't need to do a lot to, and I think this is probably going to be one of them. I just test it so you can see what I'm spraying here, you know, because it's important, isn't it? So there you are. Can you see that? Yeah. Can you see it? Let's see now. Yeah, I think you can, right. So I'll sort the buttons like that on the front and do this for a bit. And of course the volume control on off as well. Usually there's somewhere to spray them actually. So I'll go and look for it. I might take them now off the front and do that actually. But it's there, right, okay. So I need to put it in such a way as to hold it up like that. And spray down there, and down there, and some will get him. Sometimes I'm a lazy, so I don't know. I did it with it switched on as well, because I'm like that. Want to clean there, and that's it really. Sometimes you get a nice easy job like this, you know, and I've got a couple of stinkers going at the moment, so it's nice to have something that I can actually work with on a more friendly basis, as it were, such as this thing. So I'll just give it a clean and we'll take it from there. But this looks to me as though it's clean and it's ready to go. So I might use this in here actually for the VHF use. That doesn't mean, by the way, that Pinko there will lose a seat, because most of the time I listen to gold, but occasionally, you know, I do want to look at stations on FM, which is what this is. This radio appears to be demanding me side, by the way, so again, doesn't seem to be great deal of noise. So there are people out there who will change their capacities, but I don't think this needs it, to be honest with you, because it's working extremely well. It's just a working radio. After all this time, because this model came from about 1968, it's still working rather well. So in true Les Lowry John's fashion, if something is working, then leave it as it is, you know, why muck about with something that's it's working already, you know, not a lot of point, because of course back in the day, you know, a lot of engineers would probably do that, you know, What is the point changing components in a radio when the original components inside it are okay? Yeah, I know that there are people will say unpleasant things to me about that, but it, well, think about it, it's true. You know, just don't need to do what you don't need to do. So that means, therefore, that I don't have to muck about buying capacitors and bigger amount and putting them in, you know, because it's okay. If it's okay, then it's okay, and there's no point, you know. Well, I'm going to Wales again soon, so I'm sure I'll come back with one or two interesting things. But what I have got, actually, and I will actually get this in here very soon, a 1940s or earlier, a Bakelite shell that looks a bit like a radio, but it isn't. What it actually is quack medicine at its best. What it is one of these very early ionising machines. The very early ones, they do tend to to be a little bit dangerous, which suits me fine, you know, so I will actually be more than happy to do that, you know. But it is very much crack medicine, so, you know, you go on the eBay and you find all these crap, all these crack designs, you know, but this is, that is one such a thing. But that's when I get back. Also, I've got a UHF 4000 to finish up, which has been booked a bit with elsewhere. And a Colorado tape conquest, tape transcriptor deck, which is, they're interesting decks, those, they really are. But unfortunately, they can have a few problems of their own, so you need to do quite a lot with them to sort them out, you know. But, yeah. You know, it's one of those things. The car tech transcriptor, by the way, is the first deck in this deck to have not auto reverse, but play both sides of a tape from one side back in about 1960. So that idea came from them. So amazingly, even at that era, you know, people were getting into hi-fi of that kind.
A US national security spokesman said this was a positive.
BBC Radio.
Not institutions to be denied public money. Norfolk Safeguarding Adults Board found there was an excessive use of restraint and seclusion by unqualified staff at Causton Park. The coalition government had promised to close such hospitals by 2014, but there are still more than 2,000 people in similar units in England. Margaret Flynn is the report's author.
We have to see a transformation felt by people's families that are struggling to...
So there you are. It's a working radio straight out of the box, and had to do, well, nothing to it really. I'll leave it on for a bit and see, but this seems to be a bit of a non-event with this video, so I'll put it up anyway, and we'll take it from there, you know, because of course, you know, it's quite a novel radio. Yeah, I know I could have gone inside it, but everything that was inside it, you've seen there anyway, so there's not a point. It comes apart in a similar way to a valve radio. Screws underneath there, as you can see. But apart from that, it's okay, you know. So, I'm going to put my screwdriver. Hang on. Where's that screwdriver? Does this happen to you, by the way? Screwdriver with the thing vanishing. Is it just me? Ah. Where's that screwdriver gone? I had it just now. Does this happen to you as well? Is it just me? But you put your screwdrivers down, thinking I'll pick them up and use them again in a second, and they just disappear on you. Really is very, very embarrassing when it happens. Really is. Oh, here we are, right, okay. Right. I'm sure there's a fault of the afternoon, you know. I really do. The set, by the way, is an RG13, made in Austria by Siemens, and fixed in Bolton by me. Well, not fixed as such, as you know. Here it is. It's a working radio again, straight out of the box. So yeah, it's an interesting one, you know, because of course. Interesting sets are worth hanging on to, you know, aren't they? Including this one. So hang on to it, I will. And because why not, you know? Why not indeed? Yes, it's a bit of a non-event, this, isn't it? Never mind. These things do happen, and they keep the YouTube monster fed, don't they? So, yeah. Many of these are knocking about anyway, because it's, you know.
Three has become the latest mobile operator to announce it will reintroduce roaming fees for British users travelling in Europe. Customers who join the network or upgrade from next month.
Now, his work is just so incredible. 25 years ago, he founded Prevent, a charity based here in.
British government's plans to push back migrant boats in the Channel. Those plans, unveiled overnight by the Home Office, would involve...
Well, there you are. A Siemens bulb transistor radio of a type which is not very common now, a UKW automatic, and it's an RG17. And it works, after all this time, it just works straight out the box, which is, you know, quite good really, because of course how many sets today would do that, but not very many anyway. I'm sorry for the short video, but nothing else to say about it, so I'll be seeing with something a bit more interesting, so I would say. But until then, goodbye and take care.